Tess Captainville Coors Wellness Center, and I have today's Monday Mobility Flow. Today's guided mobility flow is going to help to reverse the rounded shoulders posture that we often get when we're at work and moving along, especially when we're sitting a lot all day. We tend to hunch forward, so we're going to try and open everything up today. As a disclaimer, I'm not a yoga instructor and I do not have any yoga teacher training. The guided flow is more for ease of movements. I'm not attempting to teach Vinyasa. This is also created for BCWC members and for Molson, Coors employees. All right, let's get started at the top of our mats. Here, we're gonna inhale our arms all the way up, nice and tall, reach. Exhale back down. One more time, reach your arms all the way up. Bring your heart down to center and back bend. Leaning back in the upper back, the shoulders. Press your shoulder blades up, back and up together. Reach up nice and high, neutral spine, back down. Arms are gonna come back behind you in a bind. Press them together and then press your arms down. You should feel a good stretch right in the front of your shoulders. From here, we're gonna inhale and exhale, fold it over, forward fold. You can have a big bend in your legs, lift your arms up more, and then drop your head. I like to rock side to side. You can do so too if that feels good. Drop your arms down and take a hold of your elbows. And just swing side to side. Really try to make your head heavy, relax all the way. From here, I want you to plant your hands down on the ground. We're gonna curl into a ball. Lift the heels up and curl down. Do whatever you can, wherever you can go. Everyone's gonna be different. And again, relax the head by trying to bring your forehead to your knees. The opposite of what we usually do, and you should feel a good stretch in the back of the neck. Plant your hands down. We're going to come up into a halfway lift. Hands come onto our shins. Flat the back. Pull the shoulder blades back. Squeeze them together. Look forward. And relax. Plant your hands. Step it back one at a time to a plank. In our plank, actively think about pressing up through your shoulder blades, pressing through your palms. Here I'm relaxed. Here I'm pressing up, opening up the shoulders. We're going to upward facing dog. Next, you can go whatever way feels comfortable. So you can drop down and then lift up or just go straight into an upward facing dog. From here, you can keep your thighs peeled off the mat or you can drop them down low if you have back problems. Whatever feels good for you. I know this feels good on my low back, but for a lot of people it might not. Turn, look over one side. Turn, look over the other side. To center. And roll it back. We're not gonna sit there for child's pose. We're gonna come pretty close. Our left arm, we're gonna reach it up all the way high, and then we're gonna thread the needle, wrapping it underneath our body. So we wrap it underneath our body, and then come down comfortably onto your shoulder with your head rested. Opposite hand, if it feels good, is gonna hold hands, and you're just gonna really try and stretch out your shoulders here. Right hand back under, left hand reaches up nice and high. Back down, let's switch sides. Inhale your arm all the way up, look towards the sky. Thread the needle underneath, relax down, and then hold hands and press your arms out. Plant your arm down, reach your opposite arm all the way high to the sky. And down. Reach your arms to the top of your mat and sit back a little bit. So this is called puppy pose. It's different from child's pose. This is like when your dog wants to play with you. So your butt should be up nice and high, stretching the shoulders, really great shoulder stretch here. Child's pose, our legs are apart. We sit back into our hips. Here we're stretching out our shoulders a little bit more. Roll forward and then come down onto your bellies and down. Lift up just a little bit for Cobra, baby Cobra. Hands by your side and down. Lift up nice and high. This time bring your arms all the way up and then loop them back behind you. Stretch and arms forward, back in and down. Head goes to opposite side. Adding on to that again, we come up, baby Cobra. Lift our arms up, rotate them back, bind back of the arms, lift, and then you can even lift your legs if that feels nice. And down. One more time, we're adding on again. This time we're gonna go into a full bow pose. That doesn't feel good to you in your back. Just do the last one we did. So we lift up, baby Cobra, arms forward, swing it back, bind the arms and the back of the legs, lift the legs, then bend your heels towards your butt and grab on. Now lift, inhale, fill up, press, kick your feet into your hands, really opening up your shoulders, and relax it all the way down. From here, lift up your one arm, bring it back behind you. Opposite of what we did before, legs are gonna scissor. So you're holding your hands, big chest stretch. Roll forward, arms back down. Reach your left hand up, roll it back, chest stretch. Back into center, tuck your back toes, come up into a plank, roll back into a downward facing dog, one big last stretch of your shoulders, walk your hands to your feet, mountain pose with your arms all the way up, down, one big roll your shoulders all the way back. Keeps them glued there, and that is your guided flow. Thanks for joining me today. I'll see you next week. Thanks, everyone.